Hello all. In this video, we are going to see about forging equipments. So, if we are doing some process, we need more equipments to do that process. And here, the forging also needs some equipments. So, they are majorly classified into two types. One is the hammers and the other one is screw presses. So, the hammers are the most commonly used forging equipment. They are of different types and which are used for different forging operations. Screw presses are nothing but it is a equipment which is attached with a upper ram and die. So now let's have a deep explanation about what is power hammer. Power hammers are mechanical hammers that are used for non-muscular work, which means there is no human intervention, and it is also called as open die power forging hammers. They are used by blacksmiths, bladesmiths, metal workers and manufacturers since 1880s, and now they are replaced with trip hammers. So this is the classification of power hammers. Power hammers are classified into 5 types. One is helm hammer, trip hammer, lever spring hammer, pneumatic hammer, steam hammers or air hammer. Now let's have a brief discussion about what are the classifications. So first one is about gravity drop hammer. With a gravity drop hammer, upper die is attached to the ram and is raised either by a board, belt or air, and it is allowed to fall freely on the workpiece. So this board type drop hammer is a type of gravity drop hammer in which the ram is attached with the upper die and it is moved by the rollers attached to it to attach it to the board, and below the upper die is the lower die in which the workpiece is placed, and this lower die it is placed with the anvil. So when the roller rotates, the board attached with the ram and upper die, it moves freely and strikes the lower die, and which because of this the forging action happens in the workpiece that is placed between the both dies. And the next one is about power drop hammer. So power drop hammers, it incorporates a piston cylinder arrangement. It consists of a piston cylinder arrangement and is operated either by using a steam or a compressed air. As the piston can be done either with the air or a compressed air, we are using either steam or a compressed air as a medium, and high pressure compressed air or a steam is supplied by means of an external compressor. Simply we cannot make a piston to move. Either some of the air or steam has to be passed, and here an external compressor is attached with the piston and the cylinder to supply air inside the piston cylinder arrangement. And the steam hammer, it is a type of power drop hammer in which there is a piston cylinder arrangement. You can see here the compressed air or steam is passed through this vents, and when the pressure is piston moves downwards, the ram attached with the upper die, it strikes the workpiece which is attached above the lower die, and this is kept with a support. So when the piston moves for upward, there is no forging action takes place, but when the piston moves downwards, it strikes the workpiece and the forging action takes place. And the next one is about pneumatic hammers. So pneumatic hammer, it uses either a compressed air it uses the compressed air, and it is used for making small components. Large components cannot be made with the help of this pneumatic hammer, whereas in air hammer, external compressor is used to supply the air for the forging process. So this is a schematic representation of a pneumatic hammer. It consists of a compressor attached externally along with a ram hammer, gears and some other driving mechanisms, and it is attached with the lower die and a upper die, which is the most essential part for all the forging operations, and below between the dies is the component placed for doing the forging process. So this pneumatic hammer or an airlift hammer, the equipment, it consists of two cylinders. One is ram cylinder, the other one is compressor cylinder. The piston compresses the cylinder reciprocated by means of a crank drive. So the piston, it reciprocates with the help of a crank which is powered from an electric motor that is placed outside the equipment. So this electric motor, it powers the piston and it makes the piston to reciprocate forward and backward, upward and downward. The result in the downward movement of the piston, this causes the piston to move downward, which in turn makes the forging operation. So this is about the pneumatic hammer, and these are about the classifications of hammer, which is used as a forging equipment. Thank you.